Welcome to American Girl Ideas. If you're new here, be sure to click on the subscribe button. If you're a current subscriber, thanks for the support and just craft it. For today's DIY, we are crafting a miniature version of the checkered Vans slip-on shoes. First, you'll need to cut out the shoe template. You have the inside sole, the outside sole, the inside of the tongue and the outside of the tongue, and the back. The material that we're using for the shoe is duct tape, so I have white and checkered. Trace three of the templates onto the checkered duct tape. This will be the back and the top and bottom of the tongue, or front top part of the shoe. Once you have the templates outlined, then you can cut out the pieces. This can be tricky because you are working with a sticky tape. To make cutting easier, press a corner of the tape onto the surface and only use the very tip part of your scissors, like the little nose part, and just carefully trim, trim, trim. It may seem like you're going slow, but it's actually a lot quicker. Now take the front pieces and attach them sticky side together. Carefully line them up, starting from the top. They should match up almost perfectly, and the larger one should still have some tape showing at the bottom. If you have any areas at the top that don't match up, carefully trim them so they do. You don't want any sticky parts at the top. Cut the remaining bottom that is showing into a fringe, and then I like to notch out some areas around the curve to make it easier to attach. Take a 4-inch strip of the white duct tape and fold it onto itself. Leave about a quarter of an inch showing. That way you can attach it to the bottom of the shoe and make two of these at the same time. That way the backs of your shoes are the same size. If you wait to do it later, they could end up being different heights. Now fringe the bottom just as we did before. Now for the shape of the shoe. You should have two pieces. One should fit inside the other. Place the larger one off to the side for later. Take the smaller one and trace it on recycled paperboard. If it looks like a right shoe when we're tracing it, that means you're making a left shoe. You want to use the back side with no writing on it. We need to make sure there's been no mistakes made with the printable, the tracing, or the cutting. Take your insole and place it on the bottom of a doll's foot. Make sure the foot doesn't hang off. If it does, the shoe's going to be too small. And hold it around the insole of the shoe just to get an idea of where you want to stick it. Make sure it's even on both sides before you stick it. Once you have an idea of where you want to place it, then you can push the insole all the way to the bottom of the tape, turn it upside down, and press the duct tape along the bottom of the insole. It's starting to look like a shoe. Well, at least the back part of a shoe. Now take the front part of your shoe and again align it to where it needs to be before you stick it. I like to press just one piece at a time around the bottom. It makes for a tighter shoe, the shape is better, and there's no bumps from the tape overlapping. It's okay to make adjustments with the tape until you're happy with the placement. Now take the back piece of your shoe and stick it on the center of the back. Line it up evenly with the bottom so there's no overhang. For the sole of the shoe, I am using a thick craft foam. You can substitute this material with several layers of recycled paperboard or anything else you have on hand. I just like the height that this gives me. Trace the template onto the foam, but before you cut it out, take the shoe that you created and measure it on the bottom. You want the bottom to be a tight fit on the shoe, so scoot the shoe all the way to the back, make sure the sides are lined up, press the toe onto the foam, and trace any excess that you need to cut off. Now that it's a good fit, you can glue the shoe to the sole, pressing firmly on the inside of the shoe. You can also let the hot glue cool for a few seconds before pressing on the inside with your fingers. Do pinch the toe area firmly so there's no gaps. Now take a strip of tape about 7¾ inch long and roll it down about a quarter of an inch. You have to be very careful so it's even all the way across. Keep folding it onto itself until you reach the very end. This gives it a little bit of thickness. You can also use a thin strip of craft foam, but I like the texture that this gives. Starting from the center back, hot glue the trim into place. Make sure to line it up with the very bottom of the shoe. As I glue this into place, I notice I could have gone a little bit shorter than a quarter of an inch. So you might want to make your trim a little bit shorter, but there's no going back now for me. You may need to trim off a tiny piece at the end, unless you want it to overlap like real Vans do. And last, you can glue a little logo strip on. I didn't have any red craft foam, so I'm going with the glitter black. It's just as good, I think. Now repeat this entire process, but make sure to flip the insole and the sole of the shoe so you don't end up with two of the same foot. Now for the moment of truth. Do they fit? They do! And they are so cute! You can use this pattern with several different colors and designs of duct tape. I was at Michael's and they had an entire section of different patterns. And you can even use different material other than duct tape. Be sure to leave a comment below with your next craft request. And check out some of our other DIY videos like the miniature hydro flask.